akatale kunaka ide
omulo nedo tubetuchya byame.
We have no idea where the fire started from, because by the time it started we were all sleeping.
The cause of the fire is still unknown. For over a decade, Fort Portal Central Council has depended on this market as a major source of revenue. It is home to a diverse array of traders offering charcoal, firewood, local brews and food such as chapati and pork joints. Not only does the market bring in a lot of revenue for the council, but it also serves as a main source of goods and services for the local community.
We informed our colleagues with businesses here that the market was on fire and their businesses were burning down to ash.
By the time the fire started, Peace Tigaita was sleeping in one of the houses with her children. Tigaita says she almost died in the house because the door had been locked from the outside.
By the time the fire started, I was asleep. I tried to open the door, but someone had closed it from the outside. I decided to hit it with all my energy and I called for help.
By the time some vendors arrived, most of their merchandise was in ashes despite the police and fire brigade trying to contain the fire.
I wonder why police chases away people, yet by the time they come at the scene, the residents have done a better job. Government should find a way of increasing on the fire equipment in Fort Portal. The police did not have enough water when they came to put out the fire.
Stella Birunji, a charcoal vendor at the market, said she had just stocked up on charcoal. Now all is burnt to ashes.
I am currently stranded. I had 30 bags of charcoal which I had purchased with a loan. I have lost all my charcoal. I don't know what next.
Desperate traders say they lost everything in the fire and are calling for the government's help.
I ask well-wishers to help me because I left the house with nothing since all has been burnt to ashes.
Kabundaire market chairperson Stephen Lubega says more than 30 traders lost their business in today's fire.
At least 30 traders have lost their businesses. We call upon government to come and support these people.
In the statement released by Vincent Twesige, the Rwenzori West Police spokesperson, the fire is suspected to be arson. He said this is because the landlord's house was locked from the outside, yet the owners were sleeping inside. Report by John Antusingwide for the news.